Hello and welcome to this video. In this video, we'll see all the amazing 2D features inside Graphisoft ArchiCAD 21 and all you need to know to start using the software for the first time. Leave comments in the video description to improve our next guide for Graphisoft ArchiCAD. When you open ArchiCAD, a dialog box opens. This is used to either start with an empty project with Create a New Project or to open an existing one with Open a Project. When choosing the first option, set your favorite template below, and then go to New. When opening a new document, the whole software workspace appears. This is composed of several toolbars, such as the standard one on top, and several palettes, such as the info box on the top, the toolbox on the left, and the status bar at the bottom. You can also open and close toolbars and palettes by going to Window, and then to Toolbars or Palettes. All the tools used to draw inside your project are collected inside the toolbar on the left. The Design section lists all the tools to draw in 3D, such as walls, doors, and roofs. And the Document section lists all the ones to drop 2D objects, which are very useful for designing floor plans. In this video, we will demonstrate how to work with the 2D tools inside the Document section. If you are interested in 3D projects, check out the next video in this guide. The Line tool is used to draw single segments on your workspace. Just set a beginning or initial point, and then click once again to fix length and inclination. Use the Arc Circle tool to draw arcs and circles. In this case, you need to set 3 points, one to set the center, another for the radius, and the last one for the arc length. The Polyline tool is used to drop consecutive straight lines or curves by sharing the last fixed node, indicated as a black cross. You can continue drawing straight sides by using Straight Segment, or start drawing arcs by choosing another drawing mode from the dialog box. To stop drawing, you can close the overall path or click on the last node. In this case, your pencil icon becomes black. In case you make a mistake, you can undo any action by using Ctrl and Z. To undo a drawing that is in progress, just use the Escape key. All of these 2D drawings lay on the ground floor by default with no height, so you won't see these when you preview your project with any 3D point of view in the tabs on top. ArchiCAD has several aids to help you in designing your objects correctly. While drawing an object, several dashed lines appear, indicating the main horizontal direction, x-axis, and the vertical one, y-axis, including inclinations at every 45 degrees. Additionally, a small dialog box measures the direct distance between the last fixed node, the black cross, and your current pointer, right under Distance. Under Angle, you will get the inclination in respect to the x-axis, taken as reference. If you want to insert numbers instead of using your pointer, you can type directly with your keyboard and move up and down with your up and down arrow keys. If you need to navigate below any further, you can also set the horizontal position as x-coordinate, or the vertical one as y-coordinate. The z-coordinate is always 0, since 2D drawings lie on the ground completely. When everything is set up, just use the Enter key to set the drawing point. Positions and distances use the same measurement unit chosen inside the ArchiCAD options. To change and set them, just go to the Options tab, then to Project Preferences, Working Units. Another important tool is the Text tool, used to design text and annotations on your project. First, set 2 points to create the text area, which locates the text on your document. Then, just type in the desired text, adjusting the text distribution, spacing, and properties on top, such as the font family, height, color, and style. To edit existing text, make sure to select it first in order to make changes effective. To apply text, just click elsewhere. You can edit it again by enabling the arrow tool and double-clicking on the text object. Remember that you can quickly check your 2D objects by zooming in and out with your mouse wheel. The info box on top is very useful since it shows for the enabled tool from the toolbox several properties and options to control your drawing. For example, when you enable the line, the arc circle, or the polyline tool, you can change the way to draw these objects under geometry method, the line style under line type, and the line color under pen. In case you use the text tool, you can change the font family under font type, the font height and inclination under font size and rotation, the text style and distribution under text style and alignment, and the text color under text pen. For the full list of properties, just click on the button under the default settings section. When you draw among existing objects on your document, your pointer changes shape depending on the object key points you are hovering on. Object nodes, vertices, and centers are indicated through check marks, points on the sides, and curves through star triangles, and midpoints through horizontal marks on the object itself. Besides these, you can also show blue guidelines which extend any object's side or radius on your project. If you hover over an object's side for some time, a dashed guideline shows up. If you hover over a curve, its arc will be extended. If you hover over any key point, this will be taken into account to create other guidelines that will interact with others. To delete all the guidelines created, just use the Escape key. Now, let's see how to edit your objects. To start editing, you have to select the object first. Just enable the arrow tool and click on the object to select it. This will be represented in a green color, with all its vertices shown as black nodes. At this point, when you select a node or a side, a dialog box shows up with several tools to edit the object as you like. These are divided in two rows. The first one lists all the tools to edit the node or the side selected, whereas the second row lists all the tools acting on the whole drawing. Let's check for the most important ones. Choose Drag to move the object. Choose Rotate to rotate the object by setting the rotation point, the radius, and then the angle of rotation. Choose Mirror to mirror the object by setting two points. Choose Multiply to create copies of the object, creating an array with a regular shape defined. Let's see all the tools listed in the first row. If you click on a node, you can use Move Node to move the selected node, Fillet Chamfer to regulate the shape of a vertex as you like, applying a defined radius. Choose Offset All Edges to adjust the object size by fixing an offset from its contours. When you choose a side, use Insert New Node to add a new vertex. Use Curve Edge and edit segment using Tangent to curve or adjust the side. Use Offset Edge to edit the object's shape by applying an offset just on the selected path. While editing arcs and circles, you can use Radial Stretch to fix the arc's circle radius, and choose Angular Stretch to adjust the arc length. To undo any modification in progress, remember to use the Escape key. To cut, copy, and paste a selected object, just right-click on it. You can also edit multiple objects at the same time by selecting all of them. To do this, simply enable the arrow tool and then set two points to create a gray selection area that will select all the objects that touch it. If you prefer to select objects one by one, just click on each of them by holding Shift down. The standard bar on top lists other advanced 2D editing tools. Let's take a look. The Trim tool is used to cut parts of the drawings delimited by either nodes or sides. The Split tool cuts a selected object in two. Just set two points to define the direction and then select the side you want to select first. The Adjust tool sets the side's length in order to align all of them to a defined edge. You just have to draw this edge by setting two points. The intersect tool is used to stretch two sides in order to create a vertex. Simply select the two sides and then click on the tool. The resize tool is used to size an object correctly. Take a look. Another very useful 2D tool is the fill tool, used to add fill and color to all 2D drawings with a closed shape. When you enable this tool, you can directly draw a fill drawing in different ways, depending on what you choose under Geometry Method inside the info box. You can draw a simple rectangle or a customized polygon shape by setting several nodes. In case you already have a 2D contour, you can apply fill by holding the spacebar down and clicking within it. The fill will cover all the empty space until it meets the closest boundaries. The fill that is created is an independent object that you can move outside the contour and edit it as seen for 2D drawings. If you want to keep the contour and its fill linked, just select both and go to Edit, Grouping, and then to Group. The info box lists everything you need to customize the fill appearance. Under Fill Pattern, select the kind of pattern to use. Under Fill Pen, you can choose the foreground and the background color of the pattern chosen. Under Outline Type, select the line style for the fill contour and its color under Contour Pen. Additionally, under Construction Method, you can edit the way to distribute the pattern inside your fill. You can also import images and photos inside your ArchiCAD document. If you enable the Drawing tool and click on the document, you can browse for your picture. Select it and import it by clicking on Open. This picture is delimited by a 2D contour that you can edit as seen for standard 2D drawings. You can also crop the image. Whereas if you want to size the picture, make sure to use Stretch. Now, let's see how to save and export your document. To save and export, just go to File, and then to Save As. Set where to save your document and its name, and decide its format. Choose a .pln format to save your work as an ArchiCAD document, in order to open and edit it at another time. Select a .pdf document to render your project to view or to print it. In this case, check Page Options to set the page size and layout to use. Use Document Options to set additional options to export your work, such as zoom, grids, and positioning. Thanks for watching this video. Check out the next one in this guide to see how to work with 3D projects with Graphisoft ArchiCAD 21.